Hi guys! Today we have a very different video. I'm going to the Fox Service Center, the Iberic one, and I'm going to show you the inside of the service center, and also we are going to see the shock dyno. So stay tuned and come with me!
Hi Ricardo, how are you?
Hi Andre, welcome to our service center.
So Ricardo, tell me, what are you going to show us today?
Andre, we are going to show you our service center, and we also going to show you the electronic dyno.
Okay, great, so let's go.
Let's go. Andre, so we are in the core of our service center. We have 8 workbench, so we are prepared to have here 8 technicians full time. But we, at this moment, we have 6 technicians. So here is one of our workbench. So all the workbench are prepared for each technician to develop his work without disturb the other technicians. All of them have the computer with a service center, with our service center program that help us in all the service procedure.
So Ricardo, tell me, what are those? These are for customers, clients, this is what?
Well, yes, these are suspensions from our customers. They are stored here in this room, waiting for to be picked by our technician to do an evaluation and service them. So that's why they are here.
Are these brand new? Can I take one for home?
Do you have money?
5 cents.
Oh, my friend.
So, tell me, what are those?
These are brand new forks, and they are in our warehouse, and they are waiting to be sent to our customers. Okay, so we are in our training room. In this room, we give a special training for the local bike shops, mm-hmm. who wants to receive that traffic.
Yeah, I actually know this room already because Fox invited me last year to give a full day training about kinematics and suspension theory. So The room was full that day. I think it was a great experience for me. I hope you liked the training.
Yeah, Andre. So we were pleased to receive you last year, and it was amazing to receive your technical inputs.
Okay, Ricardo, thank you. So, enough talking for now. Can you show us the dyno?
Yeah, let's go.
Okay, so let's go.
So this is our electronic dyno, and what this machine do, or the goal of this machine, is to compress and extend the shock and records the force that the hydraulic it's doing during this cycle of compression and extension.
Okay, so with this machine we can see, for instance, the force the damper does at low speeds, which is basically the pedal bob and the rider induced movements,
yeah,
and compression,
small bumps
and smooth transitions, and then you can also see how the shock performs during fast square edge bumps, fast bumps or hard landings, correct?
Correct. And we can also change the internal setting in order to fit the shock for the need of the rider.
So you are telling me if the rider wants a custom tune for his shock, you can do this and then test in the machine to see how the custom tune changes the performance of the shock, correct?
Yes, correct. We use the dyno to prove that our tuning it's producing the effects that we want.
Ricardo, so this seems pretty interesting to me. So do you have curves recorded in this computer?
Yeah, of course.
So you have to send me some of these curves to analyze in deep detail in future videos.
Of course, we will do that.
Yeah, so we have new content for next videos.
So what you are seeing right now is actually a real example of a Fox Float DPS. And this shock actually belongs to the MTB legend Tomi Misser, the Orbea ambassador. This type of graph represents the force that the damper does across different shaft speeds. In the upper part of the graph, at blue, you have the compression motion, while in the bottom part of the graph, at red, you have the rebound motion. Moreover, in the left part of the graph, you have the force that the damper does at slow speeds, while in the right part of the graph you get the force that the damper does at high speeds. For instance, fast compression movements or fast extension or rebound movements. So Tomi requested Bicimax a custom tune in order to get a more degressive damping. So the technicians at the Fox Service Center changed the piston and the valving, and now you have a much more degressive curve on the compression phase. Comparing both curves, the stock curve and the modified curve, you can see that with the custom tune the shock is much more degressive, meaning that at low speed compressions the shock will be quite stiffer, while at higher speed compressions the shock actually is quite smooth. Overall, this produces a shock quite good for pedaling because it offers a lot of resistance against the pedal bob, While when you hit, for instance, a square edge bump like a rock or a root, the shock opens the compression circuit and absorbs quite well that kind of impacts.
Thank you, Ricardo. So this is a great opportunity to see the service center, and I hope you liked this video. So guys, see you next time. Bye.